welcome to my first video about enzymes. So today we're going to be looking at enzyme structure and the induced fit theory. So here are some key terms that go along with the topic to do with enzymes. So an anabolic reaction is a reaction that builds up molecules, so that's where you're taking two things and putting them together. So a catabolic reaction is where you break down a molecule. Metabolism is basically those reactions, a series of anabolic and catabolic reactions. A catalyst is a substance that speeds up a reaction without changing the produced substances, and that's what enzymes are. The metabolic pathway, the sequence of enzyme-controlled reactions. So most metabolic reactions that happen within the body have a specific number of different reactions, and they're controlled by different enzymes. Specificity, and so that refers to only being able to catalyse specific reactions, and so enzymes are very, very specific. A substrate is the molecule that an enzyme works on, and again, they're very, very specific. And the product, the molecules that are produced by the enzymes. There's some other types of terms that you might need to know. So intracellular enzymes, those are enzymes that work inside cells. An example of that might be polymerase, so that's one that forms DNA. An extracellular enzyme that works outside of cells, so pepsin and amylase, which work in the mouth and in the small intestine. Some other recognised names, so a short name, usually enzymes end in the ASE, and so therefore you can tell what it breaks down. A systematic name can tell you something about the process that's involved, and sometimes they can be classified with a series of numbers, hence like this here, 2732. So what you have here is an example of the structure of enzymes, and so they have these four different types of structures, so primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. And so our primary structure of an enzyme, because enzymes are proteins, your primary structure is therefore the order of the amino acids, and so each of these red dots here represents a different amino acid, or maybe not a different one, but a separate amino acid joined together. Within the primary structure, the amino acids are held together by peptide bonds, and so every time you hear the word peptide, that refers to a protein. The secondary structure is a repeating pattern in the peptide chain. And the two examples of this might be a beta pleated sheet or an alpha helix, like in some cases similar to the shape for DNA. That secondary structure then folds in on itself to make a complex 3D structure, and that's held together usually by hydrogen bonds and sometimes by disulfide or ionic bonds, and that's known as the tertiary structure. The quaternary is slightly different. The quaternary is when you have more than one polypeptide chain that are joined together to form a certain structure, and that can be usually the case. The example of that is with hemoglobin. And it's this complex 3D structure that makes enzymes so very, very specific. And so they have a very, very specific shape that only a certain substrate can fit into, and therefore they can only catalyse certain reactions. And so this diagram shows us actually what enzymes do, and they technically they reduce the level of activation energy required for the reaction. And so what you have here is you have the energy level of the molecules, and so in order for an uncatalyzed reaction to take place, the activation energy required has to be quite high. And so what enzymes do is they reduce the level of activation energy required for a reaction to take place, and therefore it can take place at much, much lower temperatures. Generally speaking, to get the activation energy up to here, you need to heat the reactors to very, very high levels in order to get there. Whereas with an enzyme-controlled reaction, they don't need to be heated to such an extent, and therefore it lowers the activation energy. And so enzymes work by lowering activation energy, and they form something called an enzyme substrate complex, and so that's essentially where the enzyme and the substrate are joined. And so these are the stages involved. So you have the enzyme and the substrate, that forms an enzyme substrate complex, and then once the product has been produced, that forms the enzyme product complex, and therefore you then have the product and the enzyme separate. If you join me on the next video, I'll be looking at induced fit and lock and key theory.